everyone. My name is Sarah, and I am an admissions processing analyst at California State University Monterey Bay Office of Admissions. I am very excited to announce that we have a brand new student dashboard with features that host many important informational components of your CSUMB application and that are unique to you as an individual applicant, such as your student ID number, your Otter username, your CSUMB email, your application status and decision updates, your test scores and transcript due dates, and so much more. So please allow me to take a few minutes of your time in order to set you up for success at these critical first stages as a CSUMB applicant. Welcome to the virtual tour of your new applicant dashboard. Let's start by typing in csumb.edu in your web browser. Once you get to your home page, you will see the login link at the top of the page. Click here to log in using your Otter ID and password. Your Otter ID was provided to you in a separate email shortly after you applied. If you don't have an Otter ID or have trouble accessing your account, you can contact IT by calling 831-582-4357. Once you get to our homepage, you will see the Your Application link at the top of the page. Click here to be taken to your dashboard. This is a view of your homepage. If you look on the right-hand side, you'll see the application term and major that you're applying for. If you have submitted more than one application and want to view details on a different application, just go to the Application tab, where you can switch your view. Off to the left is an example of what you should expect to see in regards to your application status. Once you've applied, been admitted, confirmed, and are ready to enroll, you'll become an official Otter and will be notified on how to register for classes. The space below is a reminder for admitted students to pay your $100 enrollment confirmation deposit by the deadline. If you haven't made the payment yet, you will see a status that says required. Or if you've already made that payment, then you'll see the status received. In this example, the student is in a status of confirmed, meaning that they've paid their $100 enrollment confirmation deposit. After you make your payment, you can click on the View More Details link, where you can read through a message that provides details on how enrollment confirmations are applied to your tuition, contact information for questions regarding housing and residential life, and reminders about your upcoming orientation. Next, you can view your residency status. In this example, Monty Ray is a California resident, but you may instead see an out-of-state resident, international or domestic with international document status. It just depends on your own situation. You can click the View More Details link below for additional information regarding your residency status. Below the residency status is the View Important Dates and Deadlines button. You can click here to be taken to the Important Dates and Deadlines admissions webpage. Here is where you will find all upcoming deadlines that are significant to the term that you've applied for. Next on the dashboard homepage, we have checklist items. There are two categories, documents due and official transcripts due. In Monty Ray's example, we've added the non-resident tuition exemption form, otherwise known as AB 540. Now, this is only an example of what your dashboard will look like when we require documents. So be sure to keep an eye on the documents that have not yet been checked off. If the document or transcript is missing a checkmark, then it has not yet been received by the admissions office. If you have questions on the form that we're asking you to submit, then click on the View More Details link. This takes you directly to the Documents tab and allows you to click into the message regarding the specific document. Here's an example. Now, back to the homepage. The same criteria applies to the transcripts checklist. If we've received your final official transcripts, then the high school or college that we've received will be checked off. Now, this information is important, so let me rephrase. The high schools or colleges on this checklist will only appear for final official transcripts that we require or that have already been received. If you submitted in progress transcripts, meaning you haven't received final grades for the most recent term, then it will not appear as a dashboard checklist item. Okay, now that that's been stated, let's look at the example. It appears that Monty Ray attended Alisal High School, Monterey Peninsula College, and Hartnell Community College. According to their dashboard, we received final official transcripts from Monterey Peninsula College and Hartnell, but we did not receive Monterey's LaSalle High School transcripts. So to follow this example, we are asking Monterey to submit their final official LaSalle High School transcript. If you click on the message link, you will see a message stating the transcript that we require. Or if we receive the transcript, then you will see details confirming the document that we received. Again, if you need additional details on important dates and deadlines, just click the button below to take you to the admissions page that lists all the upcoming action items and document deadlines. Now back to the homepage. Interested in taking a campus tour? Easy. Just click the View Our Virtual Tour button. This takes you to the admissions tours webpage. You can book a live virtual tour with one of our tour guides, jump right into a virtual tour for yourself, or book an on-campus tour. On-campus tours are currently not available as the campus is closed, but once the campus is open again, we will resume on-campus tours. Let's wrap up with the profile tab. Here you will find the first and last name that you submitted on your application, your CSUMB email, your username, and your 9-digit student EMPL ID that is unique to you as a CSUMB applicant. Remember to always provide your student EMPL ID when contacting the admissions office so we can assist you in a timely manner. If you have questions or concerns about your application, feel free to contact the Office of Admissions at admissions@csumb.edu or call 831-582-3738. Our admissions staff is always happy to serve your application needs. From here, you can log out or simply close out of your web browser. Thanks for watching this tutorial.